Very good morning to all of you. Today we are going to start with our fifth topic of globalization, that is cultural consequences of globalization. You know that globalization affects us in our home, in the way we eat, what we eat, drink, wear, and indeed in what we think. The cultural effect of globalization leads to the fear that this process poses a threat to the cultures in the world. Globalization leads to the rise of uniform culture, or what is called cultural homogenization. Homogeneity, you know that, of the same sort. Cultural effect jo hai globalization ka, wo ek uniform culture ko janam deta hai, and often it is known as, given the name as cultural homogenization. In this culture of the political and economically dominant society leave its imprint on the less powerful society. It is homogenization. Homogenization which a powerful political and economically dominant society apna prabhav less powerful society te paundi hai, te apna impact chhod di hai. For example, McDonaldization of Indian eating habits, you must have done in chapter 3 about the wearing of the blue jeans by various persons. Their burgers, they are quite becoming popular, and imposition of Western culture is there on the rest of the world. We call it cultural homogenization. In this, the culture of the political or economically dominant society jo hai, wo apna dominance chhodti hai, apna imprint chhodti hai less dominant society par. Cultures hamesha, lekin iske sirf negative effect hi nahi hote. It is also having certain mixed and positive effects also. Cultures are always not static. They keep on changing. All cultures accept outside influences all the time. Some external influences are negative because they reduce our choices, and some modify our culture without touching the traditional aspect of the society. For example, the burger. Agar aap burger ki baat kare, to fir it is no substitute for a masala dosa. The taste of masala dosa is unique and it modifies our culture, but traditional touch jo hai masala dosa ka, usse ek burger replace nahi kar sakta. It is simply added on to our food. Hamare culture mein simply add on hua hai western culture se burger, aur blue jeans can go well with the homespun khadi kurta. Hum ye keh sakte hain कि ब्लू जीन्स हमारे इंडियन खादी कुर्ता के साथ भी बहुत ही वेल जाती है, बहुत ही अच्छी और यूनिक कॉम्बिनेशन है. एंड दिस क्लोदिंग हैज़ बीन एक्सपोर्टेड बैक टू दैट कंट्री दैट गेव अस ब्लू जीन्स आइडिया. एंड इट इज़ पॉसिबल टू सी यंग अमेरिकन्स वेयरिंग कुर्ता ओवर द जीन्स. नेक्स्ट इज योर कल्चरल होमोजेनाइजेशन is one aspect of globalization, but precisely the opposite thing we have to discuss, that is cultural heterogenization. Heterogenization means the things are not of the same sort. Cultural diversity is universal phenomena. Har society de apne culture hundi hai. One culture is always different from another culture. One culture does not have all the similarities of another culture. It's quite different from the other. We have this view that globalization leads to cultural heterogeneity. Heterogeneization means koi bhi world ki culture globalization ke karan disappear nahi hogi. It can become more different and distinctive Globalization leads to each culture becoming more different and distinctive. This phenomena is your cultural heterogenization. Fundamentally, cultural exchange तो होता ही है, लेकिन जो differences एक culture के और दूसरे culture में जो differences है, जो distinctiveness है एक culture की, that will remain with the culture. जितना मर्जी अमेरिकन इन्फ्लुएंस हो जाए, वेस्टर्न इन्फ्लुएंस हो जाए, इंडिया के जो डायलैक्ट्स हैं, इंडिया की बोलियां हैं, वो यहाँ पर ही रहेंगी. दे विल नॉट बी इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय द कल्चर ऑफ वेस्टर्न कंट्रीज. दिस इज ऑल विद टुडे स्मॉल टॉपिक. थैंक यू. सेफ, स्टे एट योर हाउसेस एंड स्टे सेफ.